everybody, it's Liliana Rowena, and today I will be going through what is in my current rotation in my wardrobe. I will be only going through my blouses and my main pieces right now because I am filming this pretty last second as I was kind of getting adjusted to my job right now and getting everything all together, but I am very excited to share with you guys what's currently in rotation. You guys are seeing what is what I call my house cleaning outfit because I decided to also pick up the house while I was doing this and kind of go through and organize some stuff. So just for funsies, this is a shirt that my sister made for me back in high school. I don't get to see her a lot, so I really like this shirt. And these are some sports leggings that I have, which I really like the Galaxy leggings. So, first things first, this is my Babies the Star Shines Bright Shuring Princess JSK in black. It is by far, I think, my favorite solid dress design, and I'm always looking for it in more colors on Lace Market because it is so comfy and so cute, and I can wear like any blouse with it and make so many different cords. I absolutely adore this one. Highly recommend. Also, the full shirring makes it super comfy. This has got to be probably one of my prize collection blouses. I ended up getting these in two different colors because I liked it so much. And this is the Mystery Kingdom Sweetie graduation blouse in pink and black. I believe this is the first blouse that I got from that seller on Lace Market. And then I loved it so much that I snapped up the other blouse. And every time, well, not every time, but a lot of the times when I wear it in photos, this is one of my most like asked about pieces that I own. It's where on earth did I get this? Also, the lace is cupcakes, which I think is adorable. Here we go. This is one of my favorite casual dresses. I think I've been wearing this to work a lot because it works really well as just like a cute office dress. It's the little tea time dress from Bodyline. It's in 2L is the size that I wear in Bodyline. I like it a lot. It's very simple. I like that all the different colors gives me a lot of room to cohort with it. The one color is the neon green. You don't really see neon green a lot in Lolita fashion prints. Alrighty, here is another dress of mine. This is just a Taobao dress. I unfortunately do not remember the brand. Is there a tag in here? No, I don't see a tag. But this is very cute. It also came with a headpiece, like a head bow, with a little bear blowing a trumpet on it. It might be one of the pieces that I wear to Paradiso when I go due to the music theme. I adore this bear blowing the trumpet. I think he's adorable. Yeah, I also worn this as a Christmas dress multiple times because I don't know, like, it's not explicitly Christmassy, but I feel like it can be applied very well to Christmas themes. This has got to be probably one of the dresses I've had for a pretty long time. Another one of my favorites. This is just a very simple Bodyline dress that's like old school-esque, but isn't an actual old school piece. I again really love how versatile it is as a solid dress. I have done blouseless cords with this. I've done black and pink cords, white and pink cords, blue and pink cords. It is so much fun, and I also really enjoy wearing this dress, particularly with wrist cuffs. Ah, so here it is. This is my favorite Bodyline print, which is the Cinderella Bunny. This was originally actually a medium, but I turned it into a fully elasticated waist because I hate zippers, and I love full elastics because I can either size it up or size it down as needed pretty easily. And the zipper wasn't like integral to the design. And it's just such a cute concept, the little velveteen rabbit Cinderellas. Here is a very simple Lady Sloth. blouse that I got to go with my spooky macarons when I saw she had her last run, and it had been a dream piece of mine for years. I had to get it, and this is also shockingly have gotten so much use out of this orange blouse. I think the only combo I haven't tried, because I think it can be kind of hard to pull off, but I want to try, is this orange blouse with my pink dress. That'll be very hard to pull off, but it's something that I want to try. All right, here is another Baby the Stars Shine Bright dress that I altered using some panels in the back. I do have to touch up some of the alterations because I did alter this by hand because I was working the night shift at like an overnight job. So this needs a little love. I think actually upon investigation, this is actually gonna go into the pile. But yeah, what I did is I added some panels on the side to kind of stretch it out. I think I'm not that big of a fan of actually the adding the panels method though, because it kind of made it fit weird around my top. I think ripping out the shirring panel and having found like another brown, like a brown fabric, a plain brown fabric that would have matched the dress might have been a better way to go about it, is to expand that shirring panel, because it doesn't, it's like baggy but also still tight. It's not my favorite thing that I have ever worked on as far as altering it goes, but I think it preserved the design pretty well. The print is super cute, and I do really want to get this fixed up for Valentine's Day coming up. To the prepare pile! Here is a very cute fan plus friend dress of mine that doesn't get nearly enough love because it's a little more formal than is easily wearable to the office. But I love it so much. Look at these happy little cats eating strawberries. I'd say this solidly falls as one of my meetup dresses. I love it so much. I really like the blue touches. I like coordinating it with blue quite a bit. It's a very simple dress to coord because I think the design works very well for itself. And I love wearing it for summer. I think it is a very, very good summer dress. So here is another alteration project that I did, is this beautiful butterfly jewel metamorphose skirt, which the alteration does still work. I think if I were to do it again though, I would have, since there's interfacing in here I didn't know about, it doesn't fully elasticate the same way that the other, that my bodyline one did. So I probably, again, probably would have kind of kept the print, but maybe redesigned the waistband part of it. This is an oldie. It's been in my wardrobe for a long time. This is one of the only, this is actually a completely handmade, very cute skirt of mine that I like. It's an orange and black, which I actually wear a lot more now since I got this orange top. Because for the longest time, I thought the fabric was so cute and I had nothing to wear with it. But now I do. And I really enjoy it. Super cute. I did the shove the ruffles under technique. I've definitely learned how to sew a lot better since then. But this thing is still holding up years later. This is a black fan plus friend underskirt. Right now a lot of the dresses that it was meant to go with are actually in my out of rotation pile. Some need repairs, some do not fit at the moment, so they're hanging out over there until I decide whether I want to alter them or sell them or what I want to do with them. But this is just a nice, plain, simple black skirt. All right. Here has got to be my most prized possession in all of my Lolita wardrobe. It is the Hey Nooly, like Phantom of the Opera print here. And this is what I'll be wearing to the tea party when I go to Paradiso. This was bought specifically for Paradiso years ago now, and it was an anniversary gift from my fiance on top of that, and it is also probably the most valuable dress I own, even more than the brand dresses, as Hey Nuli no longer exists, and this is a very, very high quality piece. So this is not technically a Lolita blouse. This is a blouse from Target that I actually got to wear for Hime Kaji, which it works very well for that as well. However, if I put it underneath a JSK, it actually works extremely well as like a very casual Lolita blouse, kind of having a similar appearance to this, but also having the really interesting detail of having this cute little daisy print on it. And I really enjoy just using this as a blue blouse for my JSK. If I used like a detachable bose, I could probably also make it into like a cutso for some like hyper casual Lolita clothing, but I have yet to do that. I should try that soon. And then here is the pink one of that, which has like these little, I'm not sure what kind of flower this is, but also has these different floral print that I use in the same exact way. And it is also from Target. Here is the bottom line clock dress. It's another actually very popular dress design I've seen from Bodyline. I really enjoy the full shirring and the cap sleeves. It's definitely one of my like lazy Lolita day dresses because I have a go-to cord with this that is so simple and easy to do that I will just do where I throw on my pink flat tea parties. I've got brown clock socks and this big brown bow that's supposed to be the waist bow, and I just plop it on the back of my head and call it a day for a very casual Lolita outfit. So this is a dress that I use for both Lolita or Hime Kaji, depending on how I decide to style it. It works a little better for Hime Kaji due to the length on me, but I can usually make it work well enough for Lolita as well. And I like the cute little swans on it. So here is this dress, which I actually love, but also think it's ugly, and that's why I love it. It's, this looks like someone's, I don't know what this looks like, but it's really, really comfortable dress. It has a drop waist. Originally, I was thinking of trying to figure out how I could wear it with Gyayu. I have yet to succeed with that, but I can wear it with Lolita very well. I'm sure I could find a way to make this work for Hime Gyayu, but I've yet to figure it out. Here is just one of my favorite little workhorse pieces that I have. I've had this Bodyline blouse since the second year I had was in Lolita. This blouse has been with me forever and I will continue to use it. It does need a little bit of touch-ups in some places because it's been through a lot, but I love this blouse. And here is the pink and blue version of my Sweetie Grad blouse. It is the exact same design as the black one, but it is pink and blue. And then here is like my OTT Sweet Dreams that I got, which is the toy doll box salopette from Angelic Pretty. I was very happy when I got this. This is very, very cute. I love it a lot, and I really like it with that pink and blue blouse, which is why they were right next to each other. Then I have this adorable Taobao pullover blouse, which is like all discombobulated right now. Oh, the Hime sleeves. There we go. So yeah, it's got these really beautiful princess sleeves. I very much enjoy this like nice ivory slash cream colored blouse. It depends on the lighting, and also the colors it's next to will depend on how beige or kind of off-white that it looks. And it is a very good blouse. It goes with pretty much everything due to the color, and I enjoy it a lot. So this is like a very limited selection of like everything I actually own, but it's everything that I currently can work with in my wardrobe, either due to repairs or sizing. And I've actually found that it's forced me to get really creative with some of my cords, which I have been enjoying being so creative with them. I will come show you the pile that right now is some of the alterations and fixes are in. Let's see here. I don't know what I've done. There we go. Okay, so it's a mess, but right now you can see I just put this over here. I've got this big pile. Some are really simple fixes like little buttons or me reattaching some lace. Some are for stain removal. And then in the case of this one, I am completely deconstructing and reconstructing it because it is the very first skirt I ever owned. It's really important to me, but the zipper was completely busted and I hate zippers. So I'm moving it to a half elastic kind of situation. Thank you guys so much for watching. I really enjoyed what's currently my wardrobe, and hopefully next year I will have way more to show you. I hope you guys have a great day, and oh yeah, I'm still getting used to all the stuff I now have in the bottom of my bio. Down below, there's a link to where I am. You can find me on Instagram, Twitter, very rarely on Twitch. I now have a Patreon. It's all down there below. If you'd like to, you can totally take a look at it. Thank you so much for watching. Please don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Liliana Rowena, out.